Okay, the good news is that there is economic recovery in the world economy. We have some big factors which are pushing towards economic growth. We have low oil prices, low interest rates for Europe. We have the advantage in the euro exchange rate. Of course, when we talk about the economy, we have to differentiate more and more between regions and even within regions. So I would stress that divergence is the key theme. For instance, in the US, there is this fundamental factor which is shale gas. Shale gas has an important impact on the cost structure of fuel prices in the coming decades. This, of course, doesn't imply that all prices can go to zero, because, of course, shale gas is only profitable at certain kinds of oil prices. But still, it creates a sort of support which leads us to not to expect the high oil prices going up again to 100 euros and $100 and this kind of range. A new factor, an important factor, is also the instability within the cartel of oil. We have seen last week the discussions in the oil cartel in OPEC, and they didn't lead to a very strong consensus on restraining capacity output in the coming years. So this could be a positive factor for the coming years, and this will be an important also positive factor for the fleet industry. Divergence within Europe is also an important key theme. We have to stress, for instance, that countries in the Europe that didn't use the euro have performed much better than countries without using the euro. Of course, we also talk about the emerging countries which were the savior of the world economy in the big financial economic crisis of 2008. But this is much more nuanced today, whereas in the beginning you could say there is high debt in the West and low debt in the East. Now we also see divergence within the emerging countries, where some of them are also accumulating debt quite strongly. For China, for instance, you have to keep in mind that China has gone through the easy part of economic development, which is taking people off the fields from agriculture into the factory. But when you want to move ahead from that, then you have to come across which is something which is called the middle income trap. And a lot of countries succeeded in having this first take off to a certain kind of middle income level, but then were not able to cross this second line, which is about creating the right incentives, a middle class which is responsive. This also implies often a democratic system, and it doesn't need to be said that this is not true for a lot of countries in the world. For oil prices to be managed well, we also have to keep an eye on monetary supply. Authorities have created a lot of money in the past few years, and whereas the US is already heading in the other direction, in Europe we are still talking about adding liquidity to the system, and we are even talking about helicopter money, which is about putting money into the bank account of every citizen through the authorities of the central bank. Because of the lot of political divergences and differences of opinion about real issues in Europe, we don't expect that to become reality in the foreseeable future, but still it's a team which is playing on the market. Interest rates are at the bottom, and whereas in the past few years every time the financial markets expected interest rates to go up again, today markets have become much more relaxed in thinking that this kind of low interest rate environment can continue for some years' time, certainly in Europe, because of the weakness in domestic demand. Finally, for the fleet business, a real big economic theme is road pricing. It's about governments trying to manage mobility and congestion. Of course, the governments also have a lot of financial problems, so they don't look at road pricing only for the public good of managing mobility, but also to fill their public finances. And for the fleet business, I would say, yeah, the big challenge, of course, is not to be only focusing on the product, the car, but maybe opening the perspective and becoming more of mobility managers in the future. And this is, of course, a big challenge. And well, there will always be early adopters and laggards, but we all can learn from these early adopters.